Now, Jessica, you and Maggie and I all saw firsthand all the damage left behind by our summer storms, the flooding in August especially. But now that the record rain is gone, there's something else left behind, a lasting effect on homes all across our state.
That's right. You know, the average year, Oklahoma gets 33 inches of rain. So far this year, we have had 53 inches. Damp conditions perfect for mold to grow in your home. And there are many mold busters on the market. Eyewitness News 5's Constance Jones is live now. And Constance, you took some of these test kits and went on a mission to find mold.
You're right, Maggie, and the results are in, and you won't believe what we found in some metro homes. Some common areas where mold hides is in the bathrooms. If you've ever turned on the fan during your shower, a lot of that moisture gets sucked in right into the fan. So anywhere where there's moisture, there's a good chance mold is nearby.
Mold can literally eat up your home.
All of these things, and so it can significantly destroy your home if left unchecked.
Our mold mission began with expert James Allsburg, who set his sights on ordinary places where the fungus finds its way into your home.
Okay. First spot right there. You see, you got this, we have a chimney here. You look right there at the top, you can see where the popcorn has come off the ceiling. It usually happens if there's been moisture behind there.
This home is more than 30 years old, so James says mold could be anywhere.
There you go. Now that's an indication that there's been water standing in there for a while.
With our $10 mold test we bought at the hardware store in hand, we placed the petri dish over the vent and turned the fans on. After 15 minutes, the test was done.
I certainly don't want to be breathing it in, so I'm anxious to get it checked out.
Our next stop, a recently flooded apartment.
All right, so you said when you came back, there was water inside your apartment?
Yeah, I came back from my trip, and right along this wall right here, there's a whole thing of water that came about 2 feet out or so.
With a simple swipe, we collected our evidence, and we also checked the air vents, just in case. With all six samples from different areas complete, our next step was to sit and wait for the mold to grow.
But...
Wow. Never imagined that at all.
In the flooded apartment, penicillium and stachybotrys were found. Both had the potential to produce mycotoxins.
That's unreal. I'm in shock right now. That's wow. I honestly didn't think that any mold would be growing here. Like, I mean, I thought this is a clean apartment. I thought that nothing would have happened, but I've been proven wrong.
The older homes in northwest Oklahoma City also had penicillium.
This is what came out.
Ooh. That doesn't look good.
The newer home in Edmond had a mold that's common this season called fusarium. Given the right conditions, this mold can also produce mycotoxins. Experts say if not treated, this will become a bigger problem.
So if you find mold, how do you get rid of it? Well, many may think that you just use bleach and you just pour it over the area where there's mold, but that's not the correct way to do it. In fact, the way you put it together, you should get a solution that's 90% water and only about 10% bleach, and that should kill the mold if you let that solution sit on the mold for a while. And in some cases, if it's really extreme, you may have to call a mold expert to come and clean it up. For live in Edmond, Constance Jones, Eyewitness News 5.
Constance, thank you. Very eye-opening. Going to get one of those tests for our home. And for some people, mold can cause serious health problems while others might not be affected at all. And common symptoms of mold exposure are watery eyes, sneezing, headaches, and coughing. If you find mold in your home and you're feeling sick, you should definitely talk to your doctor.
You're braver than I am, Maggie. I don't want to know what's growing in our house.